Vegan pet food has been a very controversial subject over the years, and with some feline deaths being linked to the vegan diet, it's easy to see why. In this video, I will be talking about vegan or plant-based diets for pets and how the nutrients it provides can differ from meat-based diets. The vegan diet is based on consuming a variety of whole plant foods, such as fruits, vegetables, whole grains, legumes, nuts, and seeds, and excludes meat, fish, dairy, and eggs. It's become popular among humans and has recently started making its way into pet food. One reason for this is because vegan owners don't want to support the meat industry's unethical practices, even when it comes down to their pets' food. While another reason stems from their pets having certain protein allergies, which often causes skin or GI issues. And then there's some owners who believe that the ingredients are just all around healthier, even for their pets. Today, there's a wide variety of vegan pet food brands, so let's take a look at their ingredients. From the three that I reviewed, the ingredients lists include a mixture of peas, brown rice, corn, oatmeal, potato protein, dried yeast, canola oil, lentils, and a plethora of synthetic vitamins that are necessary to make the food complete and balanced. While these can be a good source of protein and energy for herbivores and some omnivores, they aren't utilized the same way by carnivores. Rice and potatoes, in particular, are a common base in these pet foods and are ranked pretty high on the glycemic index, which rates by how quickly and how high the food source causes the blood sugar levels to spike after consumption. When it comes to energy, dogs, cats, and ferrets don't metabolize carbohydrates as efficiently as fats, and fats provide more energy per gram than carbohydrates do. Carbohydrates provide glycogen, which can be a source of energy for many species, but only a limited amount can be stored in the body. And when carbohydrates are consumed in excess, most is turned into body fat for energy storage. When it comes to food allergies, the problem often lies in the pet's immunity response to the protein within the food, which is often chicken, beef, or wheat. There are many potential factors that can cause protein allergies, one theory being that these allergies occur when a food is fed in excess for a long period of time, which makes sense when looking at commercial pet food, as their leading ingredients are often chicken, beef, or wheat. Another being that certain breeds may be genetically predisposed to developing an allergy to a specific food. Whatever it may be, by providing a diverse diet, these protein allergies can potentially be avoided. To figure out what foods are the most optimal for our pet, we need to examine their physiology and what biological order they belong to. Dogs, cats, and ferrets are part of the order Carnivora. While canines are labeled scavenging carnivores, felines and mustelids are labeled obligate carnivores, which means that they can only thrive by eating animal flesh. Their teeth, jaw, and digestive system are a few biological features that indicate what they were adapted to eat. The carnivore's teeth are sharp and jagged to not only tear flesh, but crush bone. Herbivores have wide, flat teeth used to grind plant matter. The carnivore's jaw is in a fixed position and can open very wide to accommodate biting whole chunks of flesh off of their prey's body, where herbivores and omnivores have the ability to move their jaw side to side to grind grasses and grains for better digestion. The carnivore's GI tract is short and simple so that it can efficiently absorb nutrients from raw meat and bone, and then excrete the remaining waste before bacteria, if present, has time to cause ill effects. Because their gastric pH is also very acidic, with a pH of 1.5 to 2, bacteria has little ability to survive in their gut anyway. Herbivores have a long and complex digestive system designed to break down plant matter efficiently. On top of all of this, the carnivore's wild cousins rely on hunting and consuming prey animals to sustain life. While wild canines may be observed foraging in between a kill or if food is scarce, felines and mustelids have been observed preying on other animals exclusively, with a few outliers of some big cats eating wild fruits every now and then. Now, let's go over the nutrients that their bodies require. There are 10 essential amino acids dogs require, while cats and ferrets require 11. Essential amino acids are the amino acids that the animal's body cannot synthesize on their own. The 11th amino acid that cats and ferrets need is taurine, which is exclusively found in animal-based protein like meat, fish, and dairy. Taurine is necessary for vision, digestion, heart, and immune system function. Proteins derived from animal tissue have a complete amino acid profile, meaning they provide all of the essential amino acids their body needs. By comparison, plant protein sources like lentils and beans are considered to be incomplete, as they lack one or more of the essential amino acids that their body needs. Additionally, plant proteins tend to have a lower concentration of branched-chain amino acids, like leucine, which is critical for muscle protein synthesis and helps prevent muscle loss and sarcopenia, which becomes even more critical as pets get older. To prove this a little further, let's look at the biological value of a few foods that provide protein. The biological value of a protein is a measure of that protein's ability to supply amino acids to the body. As this chart demonstrates, the highest biological value comes from raw, uncooked, animal-based protein. As you go down the chart to the foods with lower biological value, you start to see the main ingredients of vegan pet food. While our carnivorous pets do have the ability to process a minimal intake of these plant-based proteins, they have not evolved to be able to thrive on a 100% plant-based diet, especially cats and ferrets. It's about nutrients, not the nutrient source. This is a common statement I hear from advocates of vegan diets for pets. Pet food manufacturers also agree with this statement, as a heavy chunk of dry dog, cat, and ferret food is often made from plant-based proteins over animal-based protein, and is loaded with synthetic vitamins to make up for deficiencies, rather than species-appropriate food sources that provide these vitamins naturally. Synthetic vitamins, which are essentially chemical isolates, tend to be less bioavailable than whole food sources, which means they're less likely to be absorbed and utilized by the body. Another potential issue with vegan pet food ingredients is that there may be a heightened risk of developing dilated cardiomyopathy, or DCM. This issue is being linked to a lot of grain-free kibble as well. In January of 2020, researchers at the National Autonomous University of Mexico conducted a study on the nutritional adequacies in commercial vegan foods for dogs and cats. The objective of the study was to evaluate the composition of macronutrients, fatty acids, and amino acid profiles of all vegan pet food available in their market, and to compare the results with the nutritional recommendations of FeedIFE and AFCO. First of all, it's interesting to note that the study concluded all analyzed food had one or more nutrients that were below the recommended levels, while some were also too high in zinc and copper. However, what caught my attention was the low levels of the amino acid methionine, a precursor of taurine. However, this wasn't a surprise, as low levels of this amino acid can often occur in vegetable protein-based diets. Currently, low intake of this amino acid is suggested to relate to an increased risk of DCM. The study states the product label showed that DL-methionine was supplemented, yet its concentrations were below the minimum recommendation. As a side note to this, some research on grain-free food suggests that DCM may be caused not by the absence of grains in the diet, but the inclusion of peas and legumes, which contain something called antinutrients. Antinutrients are compounds in the food that decrease the bioavailability of nutrients by preventing absorption. Legumes, which are mutually found in both vegan and grain-free pet food, contain antinutrients like phytates, lectins, and trypsin inhibitors, which can significantly decrease absorption of amino acids, for example, methionine. So, when looking at our pets' physiology, nutritional requirements, and analyzing the diets of their wild cousins, a vegan diet just doesn't make much sense for them. While I personally am not vegan, I still sympathize with people who choose not to eat meat from a moral perspective. I share the same discontent towards the commercial meat industry and how some of the animals raised for slaughter are treated. The kibble industry supports factory farms by using the meat byproducts that are left over from the human meat industry. So, a homemade, ethically sourced, raw diet is what I believe is a win-win. Much of my pet's meat comes from my local farmers who I am very happy to support. While it may not be feasible to find local farmers in some areas, there are raw food retailers online that source ethically raised meats that are also an option. Feeding a raw diet may be a bit more work, but it's certainly worth it if you want to provide your pet with the most species-appropriate food sources so they won't just survive, they'll thrive. If you want to learn more about species-appropriate diets for dogs, cats, and ferrets, check these videos out.